Welcome back to MIDNIGHTO2 Season 1, Episode 17. This is your host, Amy. How was your day? Are you ready for tonight's podcast? Well, this episode will be the last episode of Season 1, but don't worry, I'll prepare better and come back for a better season in the next season, too. So today, I just want to talk about myself and about this podcast, as well as my book, in which I mentioned a few times in my previous episodes. So actually, in this podcast, MIDNIGHTO2, I was very lucky and I was able to talk to a lot of people. So if you haven't noticed, the first episode of this season one is called People. And that's the entire center, the entire focus of my season one, MIDNIGHTO2. At first, I centered this podcast to be a station for those who can't fall asleep at night, for those who love stories, and for those who want to hear other people's stories. That's why I started this. I thought about reaching out to more people and understanding and listening to their stories. I thought these will make me a better writer and better person. That's why I started this. And I just want to tell you, whoever you're listening to right now, that it was really difficult and it was never easy. People thought that, oh, writing a book is just, you know, you just publish, you got lucky and everything. Well, I think I was pretty lucky to have my own podcast and have my own book, but nothing was ever easy. I was talking with my best friend and talking with my boyfriend yesterday, saying how writing has changed my life and how podcast, having this platform to talk to more people and reaching out to the world, has changed my life. And I personally have grown a lot through the past 17 episodes, talking and editing, marketing everything myself. Yeah, like I was the only one behind all the platform that you see, from my Instagram account, ahcpoetry, to this MIDNIGHTO2 podcast, and to the actual website, iTunes, Spotify, Google Podcast, Podbean. It's just me. I didn't hire anyone else to edit my clips. I didn't hire anyone to do marketing. So I was the one who did the graphic design and editing and just behind the scenes, everything, replying everybody's messages, reading emails, creating my own website, ahcpoetry.com, and just inviting guests myself, thinking of different kind of cool ideas and scripting every episode by myself. So I thought it's, like, I'm pretty proud. And I'm glad that you're here with me, that you're still listening, and your support really means a lot to me. And there is a reason that I didn't want to start a Patreon yet. I didn't want to have a Discord, and I didn't want to have, like, a lot of ads on my first season. I just thought that I want to make this platform very reachable. Does that make sense to you? And I want to make it like a place where everybody could talk about their stories without getting interfering at first. That's why. So I hope you've enjoyed the past 17 episodes. And I'm really looking forward to creating more contents with cool people and reaching out to the world, hopefully. And another thing I want to share is that 2020 was so difficult, and it's also the year where I started most of my episode recording, right? And it was really difficult to have one episode going on, uploading every single week. If you noticed, I actually haven't set a date of when I would release my episode, but then I always upload it weekly. And I think it's very difficult. I have to think about scripting and inviting guests and sometimes to create really good quality audio. And sometimes I push myself a little bit too hard, and then I'm afraid that the recording's not good enough, and I don't want to waste your time. Even though this is for people who feel like they can't sleep well at night. But I just want to say I really tried hard for you and for this episode, for Midnight02, and I'm really thankful. And I'm very open-minded. I'll be looking forward to hearing more feedback and what you want to hear about or what you want to know about me. And, you know, sometimes I invite a different guests and I get feedback that I have different energy, different tone of voice, different style of voice, and just like in general, like I'm just different on different episodes. And I thought that was really cool. I didn't notice that myself. And sometimes I get feedback that I seem more comfortable with guest A, but not so with guest B. And I take notes, I try to fix whatever that wasn't good enough, and I try to improve myself in this process. And as a writer, I'm also an artist, so I really don't like self-promoting, for those who know me. I might seem pretty confident with what I'm doing, but honestly, I'm afraid sometimes that I'm not good enough, and just I'm pretty insecure with a lot of contents that I put on, and I always check times and times after, you know, each line, each spelling of the writing of the poem that I post on Facebook or Instagram. And I feel like, but I've grown a lot throughout all these years. That's why I named my first book of poetry Reborn. I never really publicly talked about it, but the name Reborn was there from the beginning. I didn't name it after finishing writing the book. I had the book named Reborn to start with. When I first talked with my publisher and my other teams to talk about the book planning, I decided the name of the book had to be Reborn. Before I went to college, so years and years ago, I was very insecure since English was not my native language, and more like I just had a hard time accepting and writing in English since I first started writing in Mandarin and different languages. So, but I think creators are all the same, and the language itself does not matter, but I just needed to learn more about each and single language, the linguistics and how each style could reforms. And Reborn was the opportunity for me. And I feel like I have reborned myself. Like, I was a different person before I wrote the book. And I'm someone better, like a better self, after writing the book and while publishing this book. So it's like a gift for myself and for other people. It's something that I want to leave to the world later on. Years and years later, when I'm gone, I will still have this book. Have this something for people and for the world. That's like one of my vision that I want to have. So it sounds very poetic, sounds really complicated, but I think Reborn is a book about love and about healing. I was also part of the design team on designing my own covers. In the end, I talked with the final cover designer about what I want the book to be. And when I think of like Reborn, I think about like life cycle and plants, and that's why it led to flowers in the end. And I was wondering what you thought when you saw my floral design Reborn book. Did you think that every poem inside is like pretty, and every poem is always about something good, and it's without any hatred, without any pain, and is the author someone who's very romantic? And those are the questions that I imagine you asking. But honestly, I included all the stories that I wanted to tell, including the past 10 years, what I've gone through, with all the beauty and all the sadness. And sometimes when I go through a certain stage of life, I realized a lot of my emotions and feelings are not digested well, and not everything makes sense, and not everything came to a perfect solution. Sometimes you can't just work hard and get what you want. And after I realized that, I thought that I would write it in a poem in a format of poetry. That's why I have it in Reborn. And throughout the 5 chapters in my book, I feel like I was very naked with the way I used language, the way I wrote. So I was honestly really afraid and anxious when it comes to writing the book Reborn. I included many difficult memories and just traumatized experiences inside. But I was able to reconnect with a lot of people after writing this book. So I feel like Reborn is the perfect title for this book. And I remember when I first got the printing, so when the books actually delivered to my house, and I was just like touching my book cover and just flipping through my own book that has my own name on it. I didn't cry, I didn't laugh. I just felt like, wow, I did it. I feel like it was right to do it. It's something that I wish I could be a little bit kinder to myself by writing this book and by having this book out there in the world, wishing that people could be kinder to each other and to the world. That's my wish about writing the Reborn. And this book is not rainbow butterflies. It's not perfect world, but it included 5 chapters of courage and all the things and the positive emotions that you feel after going through something terrible and horrible. And I thought that I wanted to end season 1 by talking about myself and the book Reborn, because I'm still trying to be a better self. And I wish that even though you might not know me personally, I want to be that person for you to, you know, light up your world, either with my words or with my voice. I feel like that's my mission, that's my calling. I want to help you and I want to help the world by using either my ability to write or I just want to warm your heart. That sounds so cheesy, but it's so true though. That's really what I want. Like, no matter if it's topics about relationships, about family, about love, about loss, I hope that I could go through it with you as I'm troubleshooting some of my problems in my life. And I'm not gonna talk about how great love is. I'm not gonna say how you should do or how people should be. And I'm not gonna stop you to feel, because I'm only gonna keep writing what I feel that's real. I want to keep everything real in my writing, poetry, and in this podcast. Like, if you know me, I don't edit out a lot of things on purpose. When I make a mistake, I just let it be. And then I try to improve myself the next time I come back. But I wasn't like this before. I was always so scared and I didn't like myself this much. I didn't want to live long, honestly. A few years ago, I was having a really difficult time. But then poetry and writing got me through it. And I'm here and I'm glad that I still exist. And I want to be a better me for people who love me and just to love them back. Yeah. And I think Reborn, the book launch of my book Reborn happened last winter, 2019, and it was a miracle because everybody I love and the people who love me, they all gathered together because of this book, and a lot of great things happened. It was a miracle to me, like a Christmas miracle, and I really wanted to cry after it because I've gone through so much of the regrets and pain, And I thought that it wasn't going to turn out well, but everything was fine. And I just think that sometimes my soul and logic conflict each other, and a lot of things are going on in my brain, and I just want to tell myself, like, well done, like, I've gone and to become someone who's better than me 10 years ago. And I'm honest and I'm kind and I want to be better. So I just want to thank you for always believing in me. I hope you could stay healthy and stay well. Again, I'm your host. I'm a poet, a story writer, a designer, a daughter, and a human. And welcome to the long night. Starting from next season, I will be preparing more stories, and the season 2 will be focusing on love during the time of the pandemic. I will be talking to more people about the stories that happen in their daily lives that remind them of love in this difficult time that we all face. And thanks again for believing in me and staying here with me. Good night.